Okay, now we'll explain lecture 7 in electronics. Lecture 7 in electronics talks about Thevenin equivalent theorem or Thevenin equivalent circuit or Thevenin theorem. Thevenin equivalent circuit intends to get an equivalent simple circuit for a complex circuit. In other words, if I have a complex circuit consists of combination of resistances parallel and series and consists of different sources, current source and voltage source, I can replace the whole circuit with an equivalent simple circuit. The equivalent of the simple circuit consists of only voltage source with a resistor series with it. Okay. So the Thevenin resistor, the Thevenin equivalent theorem states that if I have a circuit that contain resistances R1, R2, and R3. This is a sample circuit. I can replace this circuit, this whole circuit, with its equivalent circuit, which consists of only one voltage source series with a resistor. This resistor we call as R7, and this voltage source we call as V7. And this circuit we refer as Thevenin circuit. Okay. This is the main idea of the Thevenin equivalent circuit or the Thevenin theorem. Any part of a linear circuit could be replaced with another equivalent circuit without affecting the operation of the rest of the circuit. This circuit is equivalent to this circuit, equivalent in its values and its operation. The idea of the Thevenin equivalent circuit can be more explained after explaining the R equivalent circuit, R equivalent resistance. If I have a circuit with three resistors in series with a voltage source, R1 and R2 and R3, I can replace all the three resistors with only one R equivalent circuit. R equivalent resistor. This R equivalent resistor has the same value of the whole the three resistor. Okay. So in R equivalent, we replace the resistances with one resistance. In Thevenin equivalent circuit, we replace the whole circuit with another circuit. Okay. If the values of the resistors are say 10, 20, and say 10. The summation of these resistances will be 40. So R equivalent will be 40. So the R equivalent will have the same value of the whole resistances and doesn't affect the operation of the circuit. So the same current that passes through these three resistances will be the same current that passes through the R equivalent, okay? So we replace a part of the circuit with another equivalent component that has the same value and the same operation. This is for the R equivalent. For the Thevenin equivalent circuit, we replace the whole circuit with another circuit that consists of voltage source and the resistance series with it. This is, will be called Thevenin circuit, okay? The resistance that is in the Thevenin circuit will be called R7, and the voltage will be called V7. So, for Thevenin theorem is a way to reduce the network to an equivalent circuit composed of a single voltage source series with a resistance, series with a resistance, okay? now the R7, the Thevenin circuit will be like this, R7 and V7, okay? As I did before, when I was having resistances with values the 10, 20, and the 10, I replaced it with another R equivalent circuit with a value, which is 40. So what will be the values of R7 and the values of V7? To get the values of R7 and get the values of V7, we will do some steps on the complex circuit. To get the Thevenin circuit, I have to define some two points in the circuit called A and B. These are the two points in the circuit at which I will get the Thevenin circuit. So I have to define two points A and B at which I will get the Thevenin theorem, the Thevenin equivalent circuit. To get the value of V7, I have to make A will be short circuit, open circuit, okay? To get the R7 value, I have to make A will be short circuit. And deactivate all power sources, okay? To understand more the operation of the Thevenin equivalent circuit, I have to answer a question about the Thevenin circuit, okay? So, if it asks to find the Thevenin equivalent circuit for this circuit, for this complex circuit, okay? For this circuit, I would like to get a Thevenin equivalent circuit. It's a simple circuit. So first of all, I have to define that the Thevenin equivalent circuit will consist of R7 and V7, okay? V7, voltage source will be called V7 and has a value, which I don't know till now. Will R7 equals some values that I don't know till now. The steps that I will do now is to do some steps to get the value of V7 and do some steps to get LV7. So how to get LV7 value? To get LV7 value for this example, it indicates that the two points A and B are in this these positions. So to get LV7, I have to make LA will be open circuit, okay? After making the A will be open circuit, I will get another circuit instead of the whole circuit. Okay. As we said before, to make the two points to be open circuit is to remove any wire, any component between these two points, okay? For the given circuit, I have two points A and B are already are open. They are open circuit, okay? So the circuit of the Thevenin will be the same circuit of the given circuit, okay? Now, to get the Thevenin circuit, I have to make to get the Thevenin circuit, I draw the circuit of Thevenin circuit, which consists of Thevenin and R7. I would like to get the values of R7 and values of V7. To get the V7, I have to make the A will be open circuit. After making the A will be open circuit, I will get this value, this circuit, which is the same circuit of the input circuit. Okay? Now, then the V7 value will be equal V of the potential difference between the two points A and B. Okay? How to get it, the potential difference between these two points A and B? First of all, this resistor 6 is connected to an open circuit. So it will not have any it will not have any current. So this circuit will be replaced to be something like this. A is connected directly to the 20 resistor, 20 ohm resistor, and 6 resistor is removed. So to get the V7, it will be the potential difference between the two points A and B. What will be the voltage between the two points A and B? It will be the same as the voltage at 20 ohm, since they are parallel together, okay? So how to get the voltage between the resistor A, the resistor 20? To get the voltage across some resistor, I can use the voltage division, which says that the voltage source multiplied by the resistor at which I will get the voltage division at, divided by the 20. I don't know if this screen is plus 5. Okay. So it will be 100 multiplied by 20 over 20 plus 5. 100, assuming that the blue screen is not showing, 20 over 20 plus 5. Its value will be 80. Okay, 80 volt. So the V7 value will be 80. Okay? To get the V7 circuit of this circuit, I have to draw this circuit, R7 and V7. I would like to get the values of V7 and the values of R7. To get the value of V7, I have to draw, to make the A will be open circuit. This will be the circuit that I get. The V7 will be V7 plus VAB. to get the voltage across two points A will be, it will be the same as the same volt at two points 20. Since they are parallel, to get the voltage across the 20 resistor, it will be the same source multiplied by 20 plus 20 over 20 plus 5, since they are series resistor at which the voltage is divided, okay? This circuit can be shown as 5, 20, and 100, okay? So to get the volt across L20, will A here, A directly is here, will B directly is here. To get a volt across this resistor, I can find that L5 plus L5 plus L20 are series together. Okay, so to get a volt across L20, I can use the voltage division rule, which says that to get a voltage across one resistor, it will be the resistor value over a resistor value plus the other values that the voltage is divided on. All these quantity will be multiplied by the voltage source, which is 100. Okay, so the V7 will be 80. To get the Thevenin circuit, the R7 value, I have to draw an R7 circuit. R7 circuit states that to get the R7, I have to do two main steps. The first step is to make the A will be short circuit and deactivate any power source. Deactivate any power source such that if the source is volt, I make it a short circuit. If the volt, the power source is current, I will make it open circuit. Okay. For this example, I have only voltage source. Voltage source. So I will make it a short circuit. So the circuit will be between the A will be, the A will be short circuit. So I will have A is short circuit with the A will be. Okay. And the voltage source, the main circuit remains the same. Only the two points A and B will be short circuit, and the voltage source will be short circuit. So this voltage source will be short circuit. Okay. Then the R7 value will equal the R equivalent of this circuit, R equivalent of this circuit. What is the R equivalent of this circuit? What are, which resistor is series with another resistor? I can find that if I assume A will be as the source of the circuit, I will find the 5 plus 20 will be parallel and the result will be a series with the 6. So 5 is parallel with 20. With the result are series with the 6. So the values of 5 parallel with 20 will be 5 multiplied by 20 over 5 plus 20. So the R equivalent will be equal 10. So I will put 10 on this element. The R resistor will be equal to 10. Okay. So these are the two main steps to get the Thevenin circuit. I showed it using an example. you have to draw the V7 circuit and draw the R7 circuit in separate to get the accurate values of the R7 and get the values of the accurate values of the V7. Okay. This slide shows the steps, the same steps that I used to get the V7 and the R7. The V7 equal V open circuit. At, يعني, we make the A B as open circuit, so the V7 will be VAB. VAB will equal VAB will equal V at 20. So we'll use the voltage division rule 100 multiplied by 20. This quantity over all this quantity multiplied by 100. So the VAB will be V 20. So the V7 will be 20. Sorry, will be 80. To get the R7, the R7 will be equal R equivalent given in the A will be short circuit. We the power sources are deactivated. So this will be the circuit that is resulted after making the A will be short circuit and deactivating the voltage source. Then I will can find that L5 is parallel with L20. This circuit for simplicity can be replaced as 5 is parallel with L20. Then I will have L6 with in source, or I can this is A, this is B, this is source, where the resistor here is 6 and this resistor is 20 and this resistor is 5, so I will have L5 is parallel with L20. Okay, 5 is parallel with L20. The result will be series with L6. So I will have L5 multiplied by L20 over L5 plus 20. All these quantity are summed to L6. Okay, this quantity will equal to 10. Okay, this is for this example, which shows the main steps of V7. We can see another example that explain the seven circuit, how to get the seven equivalent circuit. As can be seen in the previous example, it chose for me the exact values, exact positions of A and B. Okay. In some examples, doesn't mention the exact position of A of A or B, but it says that finds the seven equivalent circuit with respect to the resistor 20 ohm. So I will have A in this position and B in this position. Okay. So in this example, it asks to get find the seven equivalent circuit with respect to the resistor 20 ohm. So the positions of A will be will be in this place. In the next slide, it shows the exact steps to get to get say the R7 circuit. So given this circuit, I will make the first step is to make A will be short circuit, so I will make A will be as short circuit, okay? Then the second step is to deactivate the power sources such that if I have a voltage source, it will be short circuit. If I have current source in the circuit, it will be open circuit, okay? In this example, I have voltage sources and the current source. So I will make all voltage sources as short circuit and all current source as open circuit. I will have this voltage source, which will be short circuit. So I will make it as short circuit. So there is no values in this circuit. For this voltage source, I will make it as voltage short circuit since it is a voltage source. So this component of this part will be short circuit. For this component, it is a current source. So I will make it as open circuit. So it will be open circuit. So this circuit can be replaced as, or can be expressed as, I have resistor 5, I have resistor 4, and the resistor 1, and A will be, and the resistor 7, okay? For simplicity, 4, would you 1, would you 7. Then I will have A will be, as source. So the R equivalent, the R7 will be, R7 will be equal to the R equivalent given, the A will be as source, Okay, so LR, LR equivalent will be L4 series مع الفايف مع الوان and L5 series مع الفايف والريزلت R parallel. Okay, this circuit L4 is series with four is series with one, and L5 will be series with seven, and the result will be parallel together. So the R equivalent will be 3.5. So the R7 will be 3.5. Okay, this is for the R7 circuit. To get the V7 circuit, I have to do, the main steps is to make the A will be as open circuit. To get from this circuit, to get the V7 circuit, I have to make the A will be as open circuit. Then the V7 will be equal to VAB. So to make A will be as open circuit, it means that this part A and B, this wire will be broken, will be open circuit. So A will be open circuit. Okay. how to solve this example to get the voltage across the two points A and B. I can solve it using by applying the KVL on the right hand side loop to apply the KVL in this loop. Okay, to apply the KVL on this portion of the loop. This loop to apply the KVL, I have to do summation of the volt at 5, the volt at the two points A and B, the volt at 7, and the volt at 240. So the KVL equation will be volt at 5 plus the volt at A or B, which is VOC or V open circuit, plus the volt at 7 minus the volt at this source, since the current is entering this component. If I assume the current in this direction, so the current enter this component in the negative direction, so it will be minus the value. The VOC will be, to get the VOC in one side, so it will, the VOC will equals to 240 minus the V7 minus the V5, okay? V7, the V at resistor 7, will V5, the volt at V resistor. So the V open circuit, the V7, will equal the V open circuit, will equal this equation, which is 240 minus the volt at seven. Will equals to the volt at this the resistor will be I multiplied by R. The V equal I multiplied by R. The R value is 7, minus 7. Will I component in this, I value in this volt, or in this component, I is called I1 minus I2. I in this KVL is called I1 in this loop, and I in this loop is called I2. So this resistor 7 this resistor 7 is common between the two loop, this loop and this loop. So its current will be I1 minus I2. Okay? Minus the volt at volt at 5 resistor, the volt will be I multiplied by R. The R is 5, well, I is called I1. Why I1? Since this this component 5 is not common between any other loop, it is it exists only in this loop. So it will the current will be only I1, okay, according to KVL equation. So to get the V7, I have to get the V open circuit. To get the V open circuit, I have to get the value of the I1 and the value of the I2. Okay, so the main goal of this step is to get the V7. The V7 equals the V open circuit, making the A will be as open circuit. After applying the KVL on this left hand side loop, I get this equation, the VOC equal, VOC equal 240 minus 7 multiplied by I1 minus I2 minus 5 multiplied by I1. So I have to get the values of the I1 and the values of the I2 to get the exact value of the VOC, which is the same value of the V7. So to get the values of the I1, of the I2 and the I1, I will apply the mesh analysis equation. Apply the mesh analysis is to apply the KVL in this loop and apply the mesh KVL in this loop. Okay? For mesh one, I have to do summation of the voltage at this component, of voltage at this component, and the voltage at this component, the voltage at this component, and this component, and this component. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I, as my equation will contain 6 voltage values. For mesh one, I have a voltage at this component, which is 5 multiplied by I1. Okay? And this value, this voltage will be 4 multiplied by I1. This value, assuming the current in this direction, so the current will be entering this element in this direction. Okay? So it will be the negative value of 84 plus the voltage at this component, which will be 1 multiplied by its current. Its current will not be I1 directly, it will be I1 minus I2, since this component is common between two meshes, so it will be 1 multiplied by I1 minus I2 plus L7 multiplied by I1 minus I2, since L7 resistor is common between two meshes, okay? Minus L240. This equation will have I1 and I2. So I have to get another equation to solve the to get the values. For mesh two, after applying the KVL in this equation, after applying the mesh analysis in this loop, I can find that this mesh contains current source. So this current source prevents me from applying the KVL directly. So I will have I2 will be the same direction of this source. L I2 will be equal 60 ohm. Okay, substitute by I1 in this equation. I will have I1 equal this value. So for now, I get L I2 and I1. I can get VOC. So the VOC will be equals to 33. So the V7 equation will be V7 values is 33, and the R7 will be 3.5. Okay. This is all for this equation. This is all for this lecture.